Well, once we get to the proofs, you're gonna have to be able to fill in some blanks. They're not gonna make you guys fill in all the blanks. That would be like an honors class. And we just need to fill in some of the blanks. So here we go. Circle the word if and circle the word then. Now, which part would be the hypothesis here, Michael? Read the part that's the hypothesis, please.
If RT bisects
angle
PRS.
That's the hypothesis?
Yeah.
All right. You see this is circled, right? So since it's circled, that's not part of it. And if you say that, you will miss it, okay? So be careful with that. This is your hypothesis. And Margaret, which part is your conclusion? Or adjacent angles. Very good. So put conclusion. Put two lines under here. And put conclusion. Is everybody clear on that so far? All right. Well, which part is the given part? Is it the hypothesis or is it the conclusion? Raise your hand if you think you know the answer. Yes. The hypothesis. So all of this is given. So on your paper, put given right here, just so we don't have to rewrite it. And which part is the proved part? The what? Conclusion? All right. So put prove. That's what we're trying to prove. Now, like I said, if one day you become police officer, you might have to investigate. So you got to look at everything that's given, all the facts, and then you got to figure out what you're trying to prove. It's just like anything, like a puzzle, kind of. All right, number two. What I want you to do on this one is draw a segment and label it AB. And then I want you to put a midpoint, so put in the middle, put an M. Copy that down. Now watch carefully. If this one's in the middle, I think you all will agree that this plus this has to equal the whole thing. So right now, put segment AM. I see some of you not copying it down, so if you lose points now, I don't want to hear any hemming and hawing. This one plus MB is equal to the whole thing, which is AB. This is called segment addition postulate. Write that down. Segment addition postulate. It's not hard. And there it is. All right, any questions on the bell work? Yes. You're okay with this? All right. Put away your bell work. On a new sheet of paper, I want you to copy this first one. And tell me the given and the proved. This should be easy if I give it to you on a test. So go ahead and stay with me now. I know you understand the concept, but I need you to do it. I'm going to read it for you. If two angles add up to 180 degrees, then they are supplementary. Now, let's go over this here. Draw a line and call it AB. Come on, guys. I know this is the last class, and we're ready for the weekend. You probably have a little extra time at the end, but I need you working, okay? All right. Now, put a ray on here. And let's label it with a B, a C, and a D. Label it like that. Now, just to make sure you understand, I want you to name this ray right here, because it was on the test or it might be on another test. So name that rig, just for the heck of it. How would you name it? Yes. Right. But what if I said DC? Would DC be correct? No, because you're starting at D and going that way, whereas we want to start from C. So she was right. It should be Ray CD. Excellent job. Is everybody clear on that? It's not hard. It's just notation. Now watch this. If I add this one, angle 1, plus this one, angle 2, I get a straight line. Does anybody know how many degrees a straight line is? 180. So write this down. The measure of angle 1 plus the measure of angle 2 has to add up to 180 degrees. Now, if it adds up to 180 degrees, is it complementary or is it supplementary? It's supplementary. So put supplementary. Make sure you know the difference. Complementary adds up to how much? And supplementary adds up to? All right. Some of you got this right away. All right. Now watch this. Put a box right here where angle 1 is. How can I name the little angle another way? I'm going to say it again. How can I name that little angle another way? Yes. Say it again. Well, we already did it that way. We already said 1. Now I want it a different way. It's longer, but I want to see if you can do it. Yes.
Angle BCD.
You could say BCD. Excellent job. Or you could go backwards. You could say DCB. But we'll say the way you did. So the measure of angle BCD. Is everybody clear on the notation? Now you do the next two. You do the second one right here, and then do the big one. Try and do it, and I'll get caught up with you. Try and name angle 2 another way, and name that straight angle if you can. I need you to try, okay? We don't want to be on the 2-year program. We want to get this out of the way and move on. Yeah. Got a question? Oh, you want to answer it?
Well, like, I have a question about this.
Go ahead.
Can't you name it like with the number also?
We already did that. We said it right here, angle 2. But now I want you to name it a different way. Taylor, you with me? All right, who can name it a different way? Yes.
For measure, so that would be measure angle ACD.
A, C, D is perfect. Is everybody clear on what he said? All right, Jada, how would I name this straight angle, a line?
I didn't know about that one.
All right, but if you had to, if you really had to give a try, what would you say? You don't know? All right. If you had to give a try on this one, Austin, what would you say?
Angle ACB.
Angle ACB. Is that what you said?
Yeah.
That's what I would say too. Now, put angle, addition, postulate. Write that down. Angle, addition, postulate. Now, you guys did really well with that. And I'm going to speed it up a little bit, okay? So let's drop down. The last few classes, I had them look these words up themselves, but we're going to do them together. It'll be quicker. So put supplementary right now on your paper. Does supplementary add up to 90 or does it add up to 180? So put two angles that add up to 180. We're good? All right, copy the next one. Complementary. Now, complementary is a nice thing in the real world when someone says, hey, you look really nice today. That's a compliment. You say thank you. Okay? Think about the last time someone said something nice to you or you said something nice to them. All right? So complimentary adds up to what? Adds up to 90 degrees. Everybody okay with that? All right, next. Vertical. Now let me teach you vertical. You know how when you miss a problem, they put an X on your paper? So put an X somewhere. I'm going to show you vertical. Put some arrows on it. Now we have two lines. Here's a test question. Two lines intersect where? At a point. That's the answer. At a point. Don't forget that now because I told you that before. Number this 1, 2, 3, 4. Now draw an arc from here to here. Angle 4. Which angle is opposite angle 4? So angle 4 and angle 2 are vertical angles. Write that down. They are vertical. Who can give me one more pair of vertical angles? Taylor?
1 and 3.
1 and 3. So angle 1 and angle 3 are also vertical. Is everybody clear how easy that is? You just look for the angle and you go straight across from where it's at, and that's vertical. It's not hard. All right, next. Here's a rule that you need to know. Vertical angles are congruent. Write that down and memorize that. They're equal. So if I tell you that angle 2 is 50 degrees, what would angle 4 be? If angle 2 is 50, what would angle 4 be? 50 degrees. Why? You got to say this. Why? Vertical angles are congruent. I'm getting you ready for the proofs, okay? If they say that this one is equal to that one, you say this. All right. How much is this line right here worth? 180, right? So if this is 50, what must this other side be? It's got to be 130. Because 130 plus this adds up to how much? 180. Did I use segment addition postulate? Or did I use angle addition postulate? Angle addition postulate. I can see how smart some of you guys are on this. All right, linear pair. Draw a line. Draw a ray. Draw a line. Draw a ray. This one and this one are supplementary, but they're also a linear pair. It's like the same thing, okay? Don't confuse them. They're both the same. Everybody with me so far? If they say linear pair in your head, you're thinking 180 degrees. Supplementary. Postulate. Now, I don't know if I should really tell you this, but we'll see. A postulate is something accepted without proof. Write that down. You just accept it. If your mom tells you something, man, you better accept it, okay? Because you figure that's the way it is. You just accept it. Everybody understand? All right. Good enough. Theorem. A theorem is something you can prove. You can prove that all day, every day. If you become an attorney, you have to prove that you're right. That's the way it is. If you can't prove that you're right or your client is innocent, you can't make any money. Don't be an attorney. All right, Euclid is a guy who came up with this geometry. There's a picture of him in the book. We talked about segment addition, and we talked about angle addition. Is everybody with me so far? All right. The only thing I want you to do today, and I'm going to leave you alone, is this one page right here. It's in the workbook, and I want to see it before you leave. I'm giving you some of the answers right here. Only that page. Now I'm going to pause the video here.